my thanks.
Well done. You have my thanks.
Thanks to you, Professor.
New path to tread. I passed? Well done, me.
Thank you.
have success!
This weather is unfortunate. Those villagers were right when they said a storm was brewing. But they were more afraid of an attack than they were of the storm. Let's end this quickly.
The thieves have taken Conan Tower as their base. There it is in the distance.
Miklon must be more skilled than your average thief to have overtaken a place like that.
This area was the site of a massive battle several hundred years ago, when invasions from the north were at their peak. This tower was built for both surveillance and defense. It will be difficult to seize it.
You know your history, Gilbert. If I recall correctly, you're from the kingdom, aren't you?
I left my home long ago. If you have any questions about the mission, I'd be happy to answer them. House Gautier has always placed great importance on whether or not someone bears a crest. Margrave Gautier has two sons. A crest never manifested for his eldest. It's not hard to imagine why he left, wound up in this sort of life.
There's no reason that crests should have the power to dictate someone's destiny. Don't you agree, Gilbert? He was just another victim of cruel fate. Forsaken by the goddess, who now demands his execution.
The enemy is close by. We're almost to the top floor.
They have nowhere left to flee, so the situation is in our favor. All we have to do is chase them down.
As you wish. I am Ferdinand von Eyre.
Battle? Put me in there!
Oh no.
I will get the victory. Aye, aye!
That's my cue.
I will prevail.
Stay focused.
Thank you.
Captain's in trouble. Hurry up, you fools!
Enemies approach from the lower floors. Watch the rear flank.
You could have at least tried. How humiliating.
Is that all? Go down so easily. One more success.
get this over with.
Victory.
A fine display.
Shouldn't strain myself. Winning's always nice.
Is full of victory.
You see that?
Here we go! Attack them from both sides!
It's an ambush!
As expected.
Huh.
Your defeat was inevitable.
No need to hold back, m'lady.
Roses have thorns.
Could have at least tried.
Should I have held back? I've been sleeping this whole time.
I went overboard.
I won't go down so easily.
I'd rather be napping.
This'll get him.
I'd like to take it easy.
It's over.
Each battle, a chance to grow.
You're better than I thought.
Sometimes.
As expected.
Should I have held back?
bar.
Myself. That's my cue.
Ah! You think you can take the lance from me, huh?
I'll kill you. I'll kill every last one of you!
Not bad for your kind. A bunch of spoiled, rotten children.
What the hell?
Yeah, look at that. I'm out of here.
Hold on.
First time fighting such a thing? Then listen well to what I say. An evil power has caused them to grow quite large. Their life force is beyond a mortal like yourself. You cannot win unless you fell them twice, or even thrice. Even if you've cornered one, you cannot let your guard down. Those things are even worse when threatened. See that barrier? It is surrounded by great power. You must break through to fight that thing. A strong attack or gambit might help to break through more quickly. If you can break the barrier, that power will have nowhere else to go, and that will likely cause confusion for that thing. It cannot counter while confused, which means that is the best time to attack. If you break down all of their barriers, not only will they be confused, they will not be able to move for a short while. Without the power flowing around them, they will not be able to restore their barriers. You might even be able to get something from them. They have such might that they will not fear you alone. But a battalion could prove useful on that front. Attack them with a gambit to draw their attention and force them to target you. Be on your guard when they have realized their full power. The damage caused at times like that is not contained to just one spot. Once they have charged some power up, their barriers will be restored. You really must pay close attention to those things. Distract them with a gambit, or just take them down before they can attack. In any case, think carefully before you act. But you should be conquering that thing instead of talking to me. If you're out of questions, get over there and fight!
Such is the fate of one whose life is corrupted by a crest stone. How pitiable. The least we can do is put an end to his suffering.
Goddess, the beast is gone, yet Miquelon and the lance remain.
It is done. Let's retrieve the lance and depart at once.
That man, his form was changed. It was as though that lance was swallowing him whole. Upon that sight, it makes sense that your students were upset. I wonder if those relics truly hide such power. Yet even still, that power seems familiar. That form as well. As one who wields the sword of the Creator, does that mean you possess that power too?
Professor, you have returned. The goddess is indeed generous with her divine protection. I have already heard Gilbert's report about what happened. See to it that you keep what transpired at the tower to yourself. People would lose faith in the nobles should rumors spread of one using a relic and transforming into a monster. All regions of Fodland would fall into chaos. We must avoid that at all costs. Please ensure the students who accompanied you understand that as well. Have I made myself clear? His transformation into a black beast was nothing short of divine punishment from the goddess. Punishment for someone arrogant and foolish enough to use a hero's relic even though they were unworthy and unqualified. Of course, that is why we rushed to recover it. Sadly, we did not arrive in time. The church will formally return the lance to House Gautier, if you would. You have my gratitude. I can see that I was right to trust you with this. Please report back. I will tell you of your new mission for the coming moon at that time.
I assume the Archbishop was pleased with your performance. Did you return the Lance of Ruin? I keep thinking about what Gilbert told us. Yes, Miklon was discarded by his family because he was born without a crest. Eventually, he became a masterful thief and gathered enough ruffians to capture a fortress. Right or wrong, he was a gifted leader. He could have been a great asset to Fodlan. What a waste! It's true that a crest can increase your magical abilities and allow you to wield the full might of a hero's relic. But one cannot measure a leader's worth based solely on whether or not they bear a crest. There are plenty of talented people in this world without one. People believe crests are blessings from the goddess, that they're necessary to maintain order in Fodlan. But the people are wrong. Crests are to blame for this brutal, irrational world we live in. Their power is granted only to a select few, whom we elevate and allow to rule the world. Have you ever wondered if the only way to create a truly free world is to dispense with the goddess and the crests? Do that, and people will have no choice but to rise and fall by their own merits.
Lady Edelgard, I question whether you revealed too much to the Professor.
Perhaps I did.
It is true that our teacher possesses a rare talent. Even I cannot deny it. The ability to wield the sword of the Creator is concerning.
I've already explained this to you. My power alone is insufficient. That's why I'm borrowing power from those people. If our teacher can wield it in my stead, I believe that would be for the best.
It's a risk. A dangerous one. You leave me no choice but to take matters into my own hands. Please excuse me.
I can't hide from the truth. I can't do all that I must on my own. If all I can rely on is my own ambition, my path won't be easy. Is it so risky to reach out my hand? Father, I swear I will not stop until I succeed. My regret, my grief, my whole life. I've thrown it all away into the darkness.
Professor, you have done well to complete such a difficult task. You have shown exceptional skill in leading your students. I am forever grateful for the safe return of the hero's relic. Just as I expected, you have mastered the sword of the Creator. Now then, I shall tell you about your mission for the coming month.
Archbishop!
Setith, what troubles you?
Flayne is missing. I cannot find her anywhere. Professor, have you seen Flayne recently? I have searched everywhere. Where could she be? She may be in danger. Oh, no, 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 what am I to do?
Calm yourself, Setith. Professor, We shall continue our discussion another time.